What's up, guys? We just beat the sunrise out here to a lake about an hour and a half away from the house. Devin and I are out fishing with Cody this morning. We're gonna try and get this top water. It's supposed to be a fire here. We're gonna throw out the plopper, the buzz bait, the frog, see what works. Just want to do a quick little intro before we really dive in. I'm gonna jump you guys over to the GoPro though.
There was something that just blew up right there. Yeah, wait for it.
Like how big.
Oh my god. Look, dude.
No.
Yeah, it's like a 4.
Yeah, I think so. If it's not 4, it's getting there.
Yeah.
That's a...
It's a good one.
Nice, man.
Better hurry up me some more.
Oh my gosh. What the heck? Oh.
Well, you know.
First bite of the morning.
Another good one. Ooh wee.
I think Cody's up to 6 or so, maybe more. Oh, Cody's caught a lot. Devin and I, we're slacking. Oh my lord. First one of the day. No way. No way. Are we doubled up?
I've got a big one.
No way, baby.
Yeah, it's fine. It's swimming towards me.
I'm gonna put this one back in the water. Hey, start your camera.
I did. And he's not that big.
That was dope. Double up, y'all. Okay, guys, time check. 8 o'clock in the morning. We started fishing about 6. My first fish of the day. Looking extra healthy. They're all chunky out here. We've been throwing frogs all morning. That was Devin's first cast on the Texas rig, and she just got that one. Where's he at? Oh, there he is. There he is. Oh, that's good, dude. He looks pretty good, man. Okay.
Kick that moss off at least.
Cody's on with another, y'all, but the bite's kind of picking up for us, so I'm going to get back in here. Okay. Putting swim bait back. I just wanted to hit him at that school of bait fish they were running after, but I want to throw the frog.
Okay. Putting swim bait back. I just wanted to put him at that school over there. School of bait fish they were running after, but I want to throw the frog.
Oh! Come on!
No way!
I don't think so.
No. He's moving with it though, right?
Yeah.
Or do you have grass?
No, he's still there.
Real, he's still
real,
there?
Yeah. Real.
Keep tension. Real. Keep your rod bended.
Wow.
Oh, he's good.
Oh, he is good.
Good one.
Oh, not with the fluoro. That's dangerous. Wow. That's so dangerous.
This might be my
that
PB.
That might be your PB. Oh my gosh. Don't let him flop out of this boat.
Out
of this boat.
Oh, that's a good one.
That is a good one.
Dang, he's fat. All right, so I got this guy on a Texas rigged crack and crawl blue baby color with a 1/8 ounce weight. Oh no, he's little.
He's little.
Deceiving.
Yeah, he's.
Three.
Right at 3.
Yeah, right at 3. Still, good fish, fat. He slammed it.
Fantastic.
Second fish.
Sick. That Texas rig crawl. Devin and I carry 8 batteries with us. That's usually plenty for like just one of us filming, even all day, of course, because they last about an hour, even sometimes over, depending on if you're filming the whole time. But since there's both of us out here and we're cranking through these batteries, I brought our MyCharge portable charger. I'll drop these in the description. You guys can actually pick these up 20% off with code Westin. Pretty sick, man. It's got a USB port. It's got one for your iPhone, one for your Android, or different accessories as far as cords that are built in. And you don't have to carry a charging cord for this thing. It's pretty sick. You can just plug it into the outlet. And so literally I could be like plugging, I could have the iPhone plugged in and the GoPro batteries charging and another set of GoPro batteries charging. You can do whatever you want with this puppy. But anyways, if you guys are interested picking up some portable power for all your goodies when you're out here on the water and you know you ain't got enough juice, pick you up a MyCharge portable charger. 20% off the whole lineup with our code. I'm gonna let those GoPro batteries charge while we continue fishing. How about that? Rigging up one of Cody's chatterbaits. He says this thing is the deal, and I don't doubt this thing's gonna get smacked. All right, we're going with the all white combo right now, guys. Check that sucker out. White bird and Cody's shad chatterbait. Oh, I think I got one. Yep, No. Yep. No. That one felt good, boys.
Oh, got it.
Yep.
Hit it hard.
Pretty hard. Oh, but he's not. Not too terribly big.
Hold it there. Over there.
Come here. No, he's good. You get out of the grass.
Hey. I was gonna say walk over to the left a little bit.
You know what? Open that. Sorry, I messed up.
Oh my god. Oh, smoked. First one on the chatterbait, and he's okay. Woo! Close to the boat too. Alrighty then.
Come here, little buddy.
Gotcha.
All right, y'all, just picked this one up on Cody's shad chatterbait. What is this?
That's a Thunder Cricket. Strike King makes it.
Thunder Cricket by Strike King. The little fishy trailer right there is a Yamamoto Zaka shad or something along those lines. Anyways, picked this guy up. He chased it into the boat from these weeds right out here, from this hydrilla or whatever this stuff is. I'm trying to figure out the lingo, man. Let's get some more.
Yeah, I saw him eat. That was pretty cool. You know what? I'm not throwing a fluke.
I was gonna ask.
Why would I not be throwing a fluke right now? Oh my gosh, I love those things, dude. I just caught that freaking 7-pounder. 7-pounder! I think it's pretty good for this type of crap right here, too, because this chatterbait, it'll get a big one, but it also picks up a bunch of junk. Okay, guys, you saw the chatterbait catch, but I just reminded myself I should be throwing a fluke. This rod is perfect for the fluke.
What color?
Oh, the only color, ice white. Y'all, I just got rigged up with the Zoom Salty Super Fluke in ice white, my favorite color. It's a 4-aught worm hook here. I think I'm throwing 17-pound fluorocarbon, and we about to make some things happen, I believe. I think we're gonna crank on some good ones right here. Give this white bird time to shine as well. Why not? Most likely.
Yeah, I got this one and another swim bait. This rod, same rod, but a swim bait rod.
Mm-hmm.
Got one, dude.
I think I do. I just let it sit there for a minute. I can't tell.
You
think so?
Yeah.
Yeah, I do. Yeah, I do.
Bring him this one.
Yeah, I just let it sink. So, like I was saying, guys, we about to do some damage. Me and the fluke, we go way back. I've been throwing it for about a month now. And you see why I like it. I literally just let it sink and pause by that structure because I was doing something. I don't know what I was doing. I was thinking. I was thinking about how I was going to catch a fish on this thing so fast. And looked at what happened. Are you rolling?
There you go. First cast with the fluke, and now you see why we like it. 3 hours, 3 fish, first cast with the fluke. Done like dinner.
Got one. Got him. She's on. I'm talking a big game about the fluke, and here goes the Okeechobee Craw first cast.
Good one?
Bandito bug.
Oh, yeah, good one. Oh, he's a pretty good one.
Easy on the rod. Don't give it too much.
Decent. First cast with the new Okeechobee Craw Bandito bug, and pulled out this little tank of a fish. And you guys can actually pick up any of these Googan baits for $4.19 a pack on Karl's Bait and Tackle. Links in the description below, so definitely go check it out.
Okay, you're good. You see that? That's a big one. Dude, that's a big one. That's a big one. That's a big one.
Come on. Keep them coming. A lot of grass, probably. Did he come off?
No. It's not that big. No, I saw him like swirl over to that sucker. Wow.
Oh!
Easy.
Okay, look at that hook set, you guys.
Yes! Just gotta let that loop sit. And that's the quick release right there. That's the humane way to do it. You don't want to keep them out of the water for too long, so it's best to just get them back in there.
Got him?
I know he's on there, but...
Yeah. Oh, yes.
Hold attention. There you go.
Come on.
Okay, hold on. That's it. That's all the line.
That is a good one.
That's not terrible. Thank you.
Wow.
Well, I was not filming for this one, but
look how fat he is.
That's craziness. He slammed that, like popping it really, really, really slow, and still using that Okeechobee Craw. Oh yeah, look at that. All right, let's get him back in the water.
Yeah, in here.
Oh, what is that, number 5, I think?
At least.
I'm about to throw the Jackal Ganterelle, you guys. I was throwing the Fluke for a little while. I think they'll come up and hit this puppy. Devin and Cody are rocking bottom baits. I'm just gonna slow roll this thing and see if I don't get a little hit. Oh, Cody's on. Haven't seen it yet. He's, the way he's spiraling, he's gotta be a pound and a half. What is going on? Is he, he's gone.
Is that a catfish?
That's a full spiral. It is a catfish. I'm like, what is going on? Multi-species.
That is a...
Oh, rod.
I got it.
Oh, okay. Got him. Oh.
Oh, no.
Not your boat.
No, you're good, bro.
Oh.
Why are you worried about my boat? You lost a fish.
Dang. First one to hit on the Jackal. I was...
The Ganterelle?
Ah, gosh, dang it. Yep. Right out here in the open. I'm going in. And I'm getting the bass. That one I lost to you guys was, he was in the 2 range. He could have possibly been 3 pounds. So I'm not stressing.
Where am I gonna cast? I'm gonna cast right out there.
Your Instagram at East Texas.
Gotcha. Got one.
It's big.
It's a, actually, it actually might be pretty dang big.
Yep, he's on there.
He's still on there.
Yeah, he is.
Oh,
he's a pretty good one.
That's pretty good.
Come back.
Oh, dang. Wow.
Man, they are serious about going under that grass as soon as they hit. Man, their mouths are huge.
Yeah, they're spawned at, you know, that's from their
post-spawn.
Trying to recover.
Another one on that Okeechobee Craw colored Bandito bug. Just Texas rigged with a 1/8 ounce weight. Man, these guys are total tanks. How exciting. Good deal. What is this, number 6, I think, for me? And I'm having a blast. This is awesome, guys. Super cool. Just when we think we're about to go somewhere else, it's like, wait, no, one more. That's cool.
They're deceiving. It's like I said, it's like you don't know how big they really are.
Cody's on. Could be a big one.
That's a decent one, I think.
Decent?
Yeah.
Woo!
The way he's hooked is weird.
That's over 4.
It might be.
I don't know. That's 3.
You want to try it? You want to weigh it?
Yeah.
They're going crazy over there now.
3-10.
Oh, no.
They're light.
3-10, so he's like
so
3 3/4 almost.
Yeah, they're healthy, but they're just light feeling. That's still a big, I mean, that's a good fish.
All right, we're going to make one final move, you guys, before calling it, pulling up the trolling motor for the first time in a while. See if we can't grab us a little donkey out yonder. Guys, time check, 10:23. We gotta leave pretty soon, so we're just gonna give this thing a shot in the grass over here.
All right, guys, well, we're wrapping things up here. Definitely got a lot hotter and there is not a breeze at all, so it is totally like a sauna out here. But the bite has definitely slowed down just a tad, but we wanna give a special thanks to Cody for letting us come out here, hang out, fish a lake that we had never gotten to fish at, and we are excited to probably be able to fish it again at some point. Be sure to drop a like for Westin Smith's swim bait fish, because it was pretty funny, as well as subscribe to the channel, and we will catch you on the next one. Peace.